Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, to MetAlert's channel, a pioneer in the field of health and safety, wearable GPS and asset tracking systems. Joining us as always, Patrick, the Chief Executive Officer, is going to give us some insight from their Q3 earnings results. So first and foremost, welcome back, sir.
Thanks for having me, Dak.
Always a pleasure to get you on. So we're going to go through the highlights. There was some good, there was some bad, but I want you to just give some clerical idea on the revenue front first and foremost, because you did see a bit of a decline there, roughly around 50% from this time last year. You want to just kind of break that down and exactly what's causing maybe some of the slowdown?
Well, yes, unfortunately, we didn't hit our numbers as expected this quarter, but there was one reason only, and it's not a material or catastrophic reason. It's basically a supply chain issue. We had a supplier send us a wrong part, a wrong component, which prevented us from manufacturing any product this quarter and getting our flagship product, I should say, getting our smart soles out the door. So we still have a very big backlog of orders. The problem has been resolved. The supplier shipped us the correct part. We will remain, restart our production in the next week or so. And, you know, we'll be back on track. This will not have a long lasting effect. Unfortunately, it had an immediate effect and impact on our quarter, but that's it. On another note, our NFC NFT business, it was actually up about 350%. And the reason for that is because that's a single chip product. And we bought those chips months ago. So we have inventory on that. And we're able to, manufacture and supply as our orders come in. So again, when we have the components in stock, or when we get them, in a timely manner, we're able to fulfill our orders and move through that. But unfortunately, when we don't get a component in, then it just screws us up.
From a margin standpoint, though, what I found most resilient here is, on the last quarter, your gross margins were sitting around 61%. Do you want to talk about how you're able to achieve such a high margin rate on these products? I mean, that's pretty incredible.
Well, yes, we, in some cases, we even have even higher margins, but on an overall average, yeah, we're above 60%. A lot of our revenues are driven from services. And so we, on the hardware side, our margins are a little bit lower, probably around 30-35%, but on the service side, they're probably around 70-75%. And that's how we have a blended average of above 60%. So every time we put a product out, everything that we put out has a recurring tail on it. So, it's like a cell phone. You sell the cell phone, but then after that, the customer has to pay the monthly fee. And that's where, the carriers make all their money, is on the monthly fee. So it's the same with us. We make some margin, good margin, on the device and hardware side, but we make a tremendous amount of margin on the service side.
And do you want to give a little insight to into the cap structure side of it, maybe some insider retail, just kind of the ownership and how you guys are utilizing those shares?
Certainly. Well, again, if you saw in the filings, in the last filings, you'll see that, our cap structure is still very tight. I mean, the number of shares outstanding in the float is under 3.5 million, I believe. Total shares outstanding is around 15.5 million. The delta between what's in the float and the total outstanding is the management team. So it's our board, it's our management team. So it's all insiders that are holding 75% or so of the shares issued. So it's still very tight. We have no new debt on the books. We're still operating under our own cash flow. And we're again, from this was a bad quarter from a revenue perspective, but long term, this will just be a bleep behind us.
Speaking of long term, do you want to get a little clerical insight into where you feel you're kind of going here into 2023?
Yeah, I mean, like I've been saying for a while now, with the our vision and where we're heading has not been impacted at all. It keeps, our story just keeps getting reinforced and solidified. The U.S. government just recently invested $1 billion into for grants for companies like ours that are producing cutting edge technologies for people with Alzheimer's and dementia. So that's a really great sign. We're seeing that all over the world. Many the NIH in the UK is putting up a lot of money for cutting edge technologies. I mean, this is a big problem. There's millions of people all over the world that have dementia and Alzheimer's, and they need solutions. And we're coming out with products and services that address this part of the population. It's a global problem. It's not isolated. It's not like certain states or certain countries have it and others don't. I mean, everybody is dealing with this. People are getting older. I mean, this is a fact. People are just living longer. We have a tremendous amount of technology that's enabling people to live longer. But unfortunately, with that comes a lot of overhead associated with keeping those people, you know, healthy while they're living, you know, their sunset years, and maintaining their quality of life. And so technology is the only way out of this. You just can't throw costly human resources at this. So you've got to, you know, put a lot of technology into work in order to maintain what's happening, which is the populations are getting older. That's a good thing. But unfortunately, when a 70-year-old person is afflicted with dementia, then that's when, you know, a heavy load comes to the family and the caregivers. And that's where technology comes into play. And that's exactly where we fit in.
I think this has been incredibly insightful. I'm going to pass that question off to the viewers. I'd love to know what you guys think about this in that comment section below. Consider subscribing, because again, as news continues to update, we'll update you here. But stay cool, stay awesome. And as always, we'll catch you in the next one.